The Boy and the Heron is directed by Hayao Miyazaki, and it is his 12th anime feature film for Studio Ghibli, and marks his return after a 10-year hiatus. A young boy named Mahito, yearning for his mother, ventures into a world shared by the living and the dead. Hayao Miyazaki is a world-renowned anime director. A lot of people love his films. In fact, I think all of his films are critically acclaimed. He's one of those rare few directors that hasn't had a terribly received film or a film that just received okay. Every single one of his films, people seem to love. And I do myself. I really enjoy Ponyo, My Neighbor Totoro, Howl's Moving Castle, Spirited Away, and that's just to name a few. This guy knocks it out of the park almost all the time. And after The Wind Rises in 2013, he is supposed to have gone into retirement. He's supposed to stop directing, but now he's back with this new feature film. And how is it? I think this is just as good as many of his previous films. He still has it as a filmmaker and artist. The Boy and the Heron is a film that I could only describe as fantastical. It is magical, it has fantastic characters, great writing, incredible visuals and animation, and a heartwarming story that delves into a lot of themes of loss, death, has our character go through a grieving process. It basically is a movie that has a lot of real life themes, but it incorporates each theme in every scene, and everything connects back to what the character is going through. And that makes Mahito a very interesting character to watch, as there's always something going on that revolves around his story and what has happened to him back in the past. The movie starts off very slow and quiet as we focus on his everyday life. And it's not like after 20 or 25 minutes where we start to see a lot more fantastical things happen and our character goes through a new world and goes through a lot of challenges and meets a bunch of new people. And while I have seen this kind of story structure before, because I was able to spend enough time with the characters and what they're going through, understand themes and who everyone is, getting a gist of what the theme and the tone the movie's going for in the first act very well, it made everything that happened later on actually feel like it is a natural part of the story, not just anything that was add on just for cool visuals and animation. And that is something that is to be commended. This movie, despite having a pretty generic story that we've seen before, it's done in an interesting way that gets you invested with characters. And each character we meet in this journey always has some sort of connection to Mahito and his past and the people he met before in the real world and in this fantastical world. Like the little girl he meets later on in the film has a very important connection to him in his past, which I will not spoil in case you still haven't seen the film, but I really like how they executed that and how their relationship plays off in the film. As for the Heron himself, I would say that that is probably my biggest issue with the film, and it's not that the Heron is bad, not at all. I found the Heron to be a very interesting character and something that I did not expect going in. I just find that he could have been in the film a little bit more, and I feel like that would enhance his relationship with Mahito in the film a lot better, as they spend a lot more time with each other. Because there are times where I feel like the Heron probably should have been here in some way, but I think it's because he is quite a show stealer here. It will take away the thunder from a lot of these characters because he is the most interesting character here, at least side character wise. And I found him to be very entertaining, funny at times, and also pretty scary when he needs to be. There's a lot of emotions going with his character and how you feel about him that you don't completely trust what he does, at least in the first half. Once we get to the later half of the film, we understand him a bit more. His motivations, his real emotions start to come out as he spends a lot more time with Makito. And I like that. I just feel like we could have used a little bit more with this character. Other than that, I found him to still be interesting and still well utilized in the story for what's trying to go for. The animation and music are beautiful. It's something that you could expect from Hayao Miyazaki. He does a lot with his animation. And every single shot has very important details within them that you cannot just blink your eyes for like a few seconds because you're gonna miss out on something very important. There's always something going on within the shot, within the story that keeps you invested. Not only that, it's just beautiful to look at. This is one of the best looking animated films I've seen this year. I think maybe behind Suzume, though I will say that this is probably a much stronger film than Suzume. Just animation wise, I think I prefer Suzume. I don't know. Both films look incredible, but definitely different styles. They're going for totally different tones and ideas here. And I feel like this style that Hayao Miyazaki has fits much better with the kind of stories he is going for, as they are very simple stories about characters trying to come to terms with a lot of personal dilemmas in their lives. And that is what Hayao Miyazaki is great at as a storyteller and artist. His movies are like canvases on a frame, put in a museum, and you gotta take in every detail and pay close attention to the stories and what he's trying to convey. Overall, I really love The Boy and the Heron. I'm trying to be as spoiler-free as possible because I really do feel like you should go see this in a theater, go support it. Not a lot of anime movies are this deep in their storytelling like this. I mean, this year, Disney is like quit with deep storytelling, and Illumination is just going for family fun. Anime seems to be the only type of animation that seems to actually be interested in telling deep and compelling and emotionally resonant stories that have great animation, great characters, great music, and fantastic writing all throughout, with emotional scenes that really get to you in the heartstrings. And that is what this movie is for me. I love it. I think you guys should go check this out whenever you can. And I'm going to give The Boy and the Heron an A. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you guys next time.